Hello friends and family, you're welcome back again to Netcode Up channel. This video we are going to talk about how to change the splash screen of Mari application. Let's say you can see I have a small application that I am working on. Now if I close this app and I try to launch the application again, the icon here, that is a splash screen. So how do you customize this to change it to my own? That's what you're going to have a look today. So I have a project. And this splash screen SVG file can be found in the resources. You go to the splash screen or the splash folder, and you can see we have the splash.svg over there. Let's move this to the raw folder. So let's move it. Okay. So when you go to the splash screen, there is no icon here again. Now let's go in there and add our own. So I have an ambulance SVG file here that I want to paste. So I'll just paste this here. Oh, so this is supposed to be inside the splash. So let's move it to the splash. Okay. So if I open this SVG file, that's an ambulance, that is what we have. So I want to use this as a splash screen. Okay. So now we have this here. Right click on this SVG file and go to properties. And now in here, you can see we have build action. So let's click on it. And now scroll to where you can have the Mari splash screen. So let's see, let's search for that. And that is this, so Mari splash screen. So set it to that and save the work. Now, when you are done, go to project settings. So right click on the project name and then go to edit project file. And as you can see from here, we have a default splash screen over here and it has added the splash screen to over here. So with this two splash screen, which one is it going to use? Let's first save this. Let's build this project. So let's build it and see what's going to happen. So we wait for this to get built and let's see what we can do or the next thing to do with it. So as you can see from here, it is saying that more than one Mari splash screen is defined. Only the first will be used. So as you can see from here, the first one, that is this, is going to be used. This will not be used. So what we can do here is, let's wait for this to get built. Then we're going to comment this because the first one, this is the first one, this is going to be used and it will skip this. So we are going to use this instead. So let's wait for the build to done. Then we comment the first one. So the build is done. So let's go in there and comment the first one. So Control K C, we comment it. Now let's build the project again. So rebuild the project. And now let's see the outputs of this. Okay, so as you can see from here, the build is done. Now when you run this or when you build this and you have any error, what you can do here it is clean the project and then build it again. So now we have this, let's run this application and see the outcome of this. So you can see that from here, we have still the blank screen and the image is not yet displaying, or the SVG file, it is not displaying, although we specify it over here. So let's close this and now let's open it again. Now you can see we have the image now. So when you run it, you have this image. Let's close this. And let's open it. So you can see we have this image, but we have this background. So how can we change this background? How can we change it? Now, the first thing that we can do here is if the size is too big, you can specify the base size as 128, 128. So we can copy this and put this over here. And also we can specify color. So D71A1A, and that is a light red red. So let's save this. And now let's run this application again and see what we have now. So you can see that the background has changed to red. So this is the debugging mode. So it is loading for the first time. That's why we have this. Now when this finish debugging, what we're going to do here is, let's close this And now let's launch the application again, stored on the phone. So let's launch it again. Now you see we have the image over here. Okay, so that is a way to change the splash screen. It's very simple steps, and that is what you need to do to make this work. That is it. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you like what I'm doing, can give me a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel, so that as soon as I drop a new lesson video, you have a notification to watch it up. Take care of yourself, and I'm going to catch you up in the next video.